Like a sneaky jalapeno in your burrito. That unexpected heat is shocking, but you can't live without it. Jeff and Jeremy in the morning. Oh!
Ah, yes.
Let's go.
Good morning. Boy, I tell you, we're moving now. I mean, we're into May. We got that dork holiday, May the 4th, behind us. I liked what Amy put on our Facebook page. I don't know if you saw it. May the 5th be with you. It was that little green troll from Star Wars? Holding the fifth of Jack Daniels. Yeah, Yoda. I should know that, shouldn't I? I'm a halfway intelligent person should know that.
He's a pretty famous character of Star Trek.
And I'm like, yes, may the 5th be with you. She put that up on Friday. Thank you. We enjoyed that.
It's happened again, Jeremy. Lake Mead strikes again.
Lake Mead? That's the one in Vegas, right?
Yeah, they found another body.
You know, in a barrel?
It's historic. I don't know if it was in a barrel this time.
Hello, the mob was there, Jeff. What do you think were doing with these bodies?
But this is the lowest the lake has ever been, right? Yeah, and so we still have the summer. Yeah, we still have the summer in front of us.
There could be the size of, I don't know, there could be a community out there the size of Pismo Beach sitting in barrels.
Last week they found a body in a barrel. This week they find a body. This happened on Saturday. They reported seeing skeletal remains at Colville Bay. That's in the Lake Mead National Recreation Area at 2:00 in the afternoon on Saturday.
Wow.
National Park Service said in a release. Hey, maybe this is boosting your national park numbers that you speak of. I mean, how many people did they find dead? Maybe that's what the National Park Service was doing. With their bodies, that all these bodies that you say have been going away in the national park system in the last 100 years, maybe they're dumping them in Lake Mead. Now they never thought the water would get this low.
There could be thousands of people there. It is a look at the 247 square miles of surface. Yeah. Now that's probably when it's at full pool, which means it's a lot when it's fuller. It's lower now, and that's going to keep shrinking. But 28.23 miles.
Have you seen the picture of the intake valve that's sitting up out of the water? Chrome. There? No. This is an intake valve that has been supplying Las Vegas with its water since 1971.
Okay.
And it has never gotten below this intake valve. I want to say the intake valve.
I mean, I've been to the dam and I've seen, those, but I don't think you're talking about that. You're talking about something else?
Yeah, I'm talking about just an area that is of Lake Mead, of the watershed there. There's this one intake valve that is of many.
I'm Googling
of many
it.
Intake valve. And it's got to be a good 5-6 feet out of the water already.
Oh, it just looks like a big drain for like you'd see a sewer. And it's just kind of sticking out next to a rock cove or something?
Yes.
Okay, I'm looking at it. Yeah, wow.
That has never been out of the water.
It's never been exposed.
Since 1971. And now May. How do you like it if you're a Las Vegas resident and you know you've been drinking dead body water?
Oh,
or you've
God,
been bathing right? in dead body water?
Well, I mean, think about it. I lived in the Five Cities for a number of years, and people are peeing in Lake Lopez and we're drinking that. So, and people die in Lake Lopez too, unfortunately. Sorry if you've lost anybody in Lake
But Lopez. They recover the bodies.
Sometimes they do, and sometimes you don't know. I mean, I'm sure they have.
But the story just goes away?
It's a pretty small lake compared to Lake Mead.
Yeah.
Yeah, but, that's part of it. That's life, unless you're on a well. And, that's just, it's life, man. And, it's okay. It's not a big deal. It's all filtered out.
It's all organic material?
It's all processed, yeah. I think I would rather drink water that a dead body had, decayed in. That's not what is it called when you die? And you not decay, but you know what I mean.
Decomposed?
Decomposed, thank you. Over time, I would rather drink water that had been treated from decomposed waste or humans than actual chemicals or other wastes.
This is a little bit different this time because this was skeletal remains.
Right.
Whereas before, the body was somewhat preserved.
Oh, so it was a recent body.
They think, no. They think based on the clothes and the shoes that were on the body that it happened sometime between the mid-70s and the mid-80s. It's been around as long as you and I have.
Oh, the one that they found in the barrel? Well, it must have been sealed really well. If it was still, you know, if there was still somewhat preserved, I would imagine that has to be pretty much airtight. Because if water gets in there, that's going to help the decomposition.
Well, you've heard the stories about Tahoe because the water's so cold that they believe, and it's so deep. Tahoe's so deep.
Yeah, there's underwater water caves that connect with other major deep bodies of water. I've read stuff about that, and they go out to the ocean. And that's why they think there could be a sea monster in there. Sea monster.
I don't know about that.
What is the story about Tahoe? You said the water's so cold.
Well, I don't know. It's so deep, and that the water's so cold that, and there was a lot of mob activity, you know, back in the 50s and the 60s.
Tahoe. That's where they dumped.
Remember, Godfather? They bought a house on Lake Tahoe. You know, I mean,
what was that? So just a processed dead body?
They think that, you know, there's some cement shoe situations there, but the water's so cold in Tahoe that it would preserve the bodies, which is never fun.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if it's bad. I mean, maybe it is. I don't know. You know, that's why I'm not a diver. I've heard river systems where they have eddies that have a lot of current down there that, you know, they found bodies 100, 120 feet down, just circling in what they call a hydraulic. Because the hydraulic is like what it looks like when you take the water out of the tub and it forms that kind of whirlpool thing. And in a river with current, it'll get down there. And they found people just down there held underwater by this hydraulic current.
Yeah.
And then just spinning. And can you imagine going down there and then seeing a body just not just floating there, but spinning? All I think of is Friday the 13th when Jason Voorhees, they chained him to the bottom of the lake. Do you remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Son of a bitch. That's creepy.
Nope. Went to high school with a guy named Jason Voorhees.
That's right.
He was born in 1976, right before the movie came out. And I bet you they could go. I mean, like, why wouldn't I? Okay. The kid was like, I don't know. The kid was like two or three when the movie came out. At that point in time, can you change your kid's name?
Yes.
Fairly easy.
Yeah, but you didn't know it was going to be, you know, a phenomenon or whatever.
Have him do like as my brother-in-law, his name's Richard, and his last name's Simmons, but he goes by something totally different.
Well, you could go by Ricky. He could go by Dick.
Dick.
But when your name Rick. Is Jason, what is the short J?
J.
Go for Jason. J. Yeah. Yeah. I think that works with any name that starts with a J. You can just go by J.
Jason didn't go by J.
He went by Jason Voorhees.
He went by Jason Voorhees, and everybody like...
You have class with him when they do the attendance, and then the substitute teacher would come in? That must have tripped out subs all the time. Like, all right, Jeff Kingman, Jason Voorhees?
All right, who's playing a trick on me here?
Today, keep listening for two songs from the same artist played back-to-back. It's The Big Gas Grab, presented by Perry Ford Lincoln. And if you hear that, make sure you text the word gas in to get qualified for that $500. Flogging Molly at 8:40. Jim Gaffigan. We got tickets to that show 9:40 later if you know the show.
Spending 4 hours in a box together every day can make you say crazy things. Jeff and Jeremy in the morning.
Eminem went into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. The induction ceremony's coming up. But he's going in. Been getting a lot of flack for it, apparently. The Hall of Fame has.
Why?
And the director is saying that he deserves to be there as much. Director, CEO of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Why does he have to show his ass in this video? If you forgot, Eminem shows his butt about 3 minutes into that video. Greg Harris is getting a lot of flack for it, and he says he deserves to be there.
For a lot of years, people asked about hip-hop. Eminem, you listen to his music, it is as hard-hitting and straight ahead as any metal song. It's a chest punch with a message and with a power and with a rhythm and with a band. So yeah, we're thrilled he's going in. First year of eligibility, it's a big statement.
What's your favorite Eminem song?
This song. That's why I'm playing it. This is a great song. This is a motivating son of a bitch right here, if you ask me. This is, for me, when I attempt to work out. And I'm starting to feel like, let's get off this thing. I'll do more tomorrow. I try to get this on very quickly. Gets me motivated. I feel like if there was ever a bully and you were getting ready to fight a bully, this would be a great song to get yourself hyped up to go punch him in the face.
Yeah.
It's a battle song.
My favorite one's one that didn't get played all that much, but it's a pretty good song. It was Stan, the one about the super fan that would ride him.
Yeah, that killed his wife and put her in the trunk of his car.
Yeah. That was a crazy song.
That is a dark song.
It's such a dark song, and I remember thinking, man, dude, this guy's got some demons, man.
Well, what I really remember about that song, and I know probably most people don't give a crap since this is classic rock, but I know we have a lot of people that cross over. A lot of people that listen to to that also.
Well,
when they were
listening to that then, and then they grew up.
Yeah, and you were listening to whatever. But Stan, you remember the songwriting that went into writing that song and the detail that he went into, and the way he was able to tell that story in 3 minutes and, I don't know, 30-something seconds.
It's a long song. It's like 5 minutes long.
Oh, okay, 5 minutes. Yeah. Still, it was crazy. But yeah, I think Eminem, I mean, you know what, listen, I mean, Madonna's in there, Michael Jackson's in there. It's obviously the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame is turned into something that isn't just what the name says. You got to open your mind, man. Here's a little bit more.
He came in and helped induct Run DMC, and then he popped up on stage at the last year's induction with LL Cool J when they brought the house down during his induction ceremony. Love that he's paying a nod to his influences, and now he's the one in the spotlight. He influenced so many more.
This is going to be a very unpopular take with the people listening to the sound of our voices right now, but I hate it when people say, it's the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, man. It's not the Hip Hop Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
I hate it.
I know, I do too. I mean, and Dolly is going to go in as well. I mean, this is a really, this is just a music Hall of Fame. I mean, I know it's called the Rock and Roll. I'd rather it be called the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and celebrate all genres of great artists that have made strides and made differences or whatever it is that they, determined to put them up for induction.
That's what rock and roll started out as popular music, you know? Yeah. I mean, it's pop music. It's the Pop Music Hall of Fame. If you don't like it, call it the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Start up a classic rock and roll Hall of Fame. See how well it does.
Well, kind of like he was making the example in the beginning in there. You know, he could compare it to any like metal or heavier song or this gut punch that you get with some of that stuff, and you would consider that. I don't know where you draw the line at, but I mean, anyways, good for Eminem. I'm glad that he got in. And regardless of if you like the dude or not, he's super talented. And
this is the poll question right now. Eminem is in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Do you think he's deserved
of it? KZOZ.com. It's brought to you by SurfNet Communications, your leader in broadband rural internet. Check him out, SurfNetUSA.com.
Careful, you don't want to learn from this. Jeff and Jeremy in the morning on 93.3. KZOZ.
Here comes Dumbass of the Day, brought to you by California Diesel and RV. If you've got a truck, an RV, a pickup truck, if you have fleet vehicles that you need managed, these are the people that can do it for you. It's California Diesel and RV. They're in Oceano. Stop by and see them at 1189 Pike Lane in Oceano. Or you can follow the links, California Diesel and RV at KZOZ.com.
How pathetic can some people be?
So now I joined a gym. I pay money to go to a building where I trick my body into thinking my life is hard so it doesn't give up. Some people don't like the gym. They think it's ridiculous to pay money to go to a gym. I've had conversations with friends of mine. They're like, that's so dumb. Why don't you just go run? You can go jog. You can do push-ups. You can do sit-ups. You can take care of that yourself. I'm like, you have never seen an episode of Law and Order. Because if you had, you would know that 50% of murder victims are found by joggers. The other 50% of murder victims are joggers. I have never seen a dead body in my gym. That should be the slogan for every gym. Come on down to Jill's Fitness. We got spin classes. We got yoga studio. Very few dead bodies. Industry leader, 3 years running. Fewest corpses. Look it up.
Dumbass of the day. 93.3 KZOZ.
Off to Pennsylvania for this dumbass of the day. Here's the TV station.
A Tyrone man is behind bars after allegedly driving himself to his arraignment on DUI charges while drunk. Police say 58-year-old Lawrence Williams was already on probation for two other DUI cases from 2021. Now, if he does post bail, he'll be put on supervised release with the Blair County Adult Probation Department.
So there you go. So obviously, this guy's working a case for having a problem and deferred prosecution. Because I remember at some point when I was dealing with this, if you had a problem, if you said you were an alcoholic, they would give you this deferred prosecution. And it sounded better at the time because you would, maybe not have a DUI on your record, but
yeah, they would. It would be
the next 5 years of your life. You'd have to go to classes, and
yeah, it would help out your insurance situation and your driver's license situation,
which is so screwed up. Okay, I have a disease. I can't stop drinking. Give me the keys back to my car. It just doesn't make any sense. I can't stop myself, but give me the keys back to my car. I mean, no, if anybody should not have keys to a car,
it should be somebody
who can't control their drinking.
Can't stop their it's funny how they outfit the...
That's just common sense to me.
The ignition with these breathalyzers. Have you ever seen one of those? They do those, and that's the weirdest thing, because it's like, okay, if it's gotten to this point where you got to get the ignition switch for being able to drive your car, then just take the keys away at that point. I mean, and go get some help.
We knew a girl in college. I can't remember her name. Damn it. She's friends with Ernie. She had a couple DUIs. I think that's how we knew her. I could be getting that wrong. But anyways.
You knew her from getting the DUIs?
No, I just knew her that when in college she had gotten a couple DUIs. She was in her early 20s, making all kinds of bad decisions, mainly drinking and driving. Other than that, she was a really nice girl. But she get all hammered. And I remember she asked me if I would go blow into her thing because she had one of these attached to her ignition. And I was like, well, I've already had 3 beers. She goes, you should be fine. She probably already had about 6 drinks. She was tired.
Did she look you up from head to toe and say, oh, you should be just fine? Because that would be like the biggest insult of all time.
Why is that?
Well, your body weight, you should be fine. 3 beers.
Oh, but I was a lot thinner in college, remember? I wasn't. Well, I was, 40 pounds lighter than I am now.
You were getting there.
I was getting there.
You were on your way.
I have pictures. I'm like, God, I'd give anything to be back there. That's the goal without having to do all the work. So anyways, he was arrested. Once he got there, they could tell he was drunk. They could smell the booze on him. And so he's, I don't know what's going to happen. I mean, he just drives no matter what. So I don't know what they're going to do.
I'll tell you what's going to happen. And this is what the system should be the dumbass on this one. He'll say, oh, yeah, well, I have a problem. And they're like, okay, well, we're not going to penalize you for having a problem, but we got to make sure that you're safe. So you're not allowed to drive for 6 months, and you have to go do this program. And then as long as you go to this program, prove that you got on the program, we'll let you out. And he'll be back at it again because guess what? He says he has a problem.
Yeah.
It's a disease. It's
but
not
they'll
his
keep
fault.
Giving it's, him his keys back.
It's the disease.
He'll get
fault.
Keys from somebody else. He's already taken out a fence and a mailbox. First DUI was a fence. Second DUI, the one he was showing up to report for, was he took out a mailbox.
So hopefully the third one is not an issue of a body or somebody.
I feel bad for this guy because I like to drink, but I always plan ahead and make sure I don't find myself in a situation where I think, I'm fine.
I think we've reached a point in society where there's enough options to where you can't use, I'm sorry, I have a disease as a defense.
Right.
When it comes to drinking and driving.
Yeah, exactly. No, they need to probably They need to step up the punishment on that, because obviously this guy's already drove drunk to the courthouse where he was going to get tried for a DUI. Congratulations, Lawrence Williams. You are Jeff and Jeremy's
Dumbass of the Day. It's Jeff and Jeremy in the Morning on 93.3 KZOZ. Subscribe to the Jeff and Jeremy podcast now on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google, and YouTube. It's your Central Coast commute-friendly podcast.